Hi, welcome to SA Insight. My name is Dumelo Mara, and in today's episode, we are going to look at top 10 South African foods. If you set foot on South African soil, don't leave before you've enjoyed a traditional alfresco braai as much as for the barbecued food for the cultural experience. Many tourists flock to South Africa because of its rich history and its beautiful scenery. But South Africa is well known for its cultural foods and wine. So here are the top 10 South African foods you should have. At number 10, we have Melktert. Similar to the British custard tart or the Portuguese pasties, Melktert consists of a pastry case filled with milk, eggs and sugar, which is usually thickened with flour. The finished tart is traditionally dusted with cinnamon, a real South African comfort dish. This is served as a dessert and it is also available in many bakeries in South Africa. Number 9. Bobotie. Another dish thought to have been brought to South Africa by Asian settlers, Bobotie is now the national dish of the country and cooked in many houses and restaurants. Minced meat is smeared with spices, usually curry powder, herbs and dried fruit, then topped with a mixture of eggs and milk and baked until set. Others might ask where this dish comes from because of its name. One might think it to have originated from Bobotok, an Indonesian dish which consisted of totally different ingredients. The first recipe of Bobotie appeared in a Dutch cookbook in 1609. Afterwards, it was taken to South Africa and adopted by the Cape Malay community. At number 8, Amarula Don Pedro. This cocktail comb dessert uses South African Amarula, a cream liqueur made from the indigenous Amarula fruit blended with ice cream. Find it in every bar or take a bottle of Amarula home with you. This alcoholic dessert recipe consists of ice cream, fresh thick cream, crumbled chocolate bars, and some people add their own flavors on the recipe to even make it more exquisite. And put this all in a blender with a straw, then voila, you have yourself an Amarula Don Pedro. Number 7. Bunny chow. This street food of Durban has become popular across South Africa and it is new, starting to hit the food market even in London. Hollowed out loaves of bread stuffed with spicy curry were originally created by the immigrant Indian community in the Natal area of Durban and served to workers for lunch. Try chicken, pork or vegetarian varieties containing lettuce and beans. Many South Africans argue that there is no difference between a bunny chow and a kota. Comment down below and share your thoughts. Number 6. Braai or Shisa nyama. For a real taste of South African food, an authentic braai or Shisa nyama in Zulu, which means burnt meat, is an experience you do not want to miss. Braais originated in townships of Johannesburg with butchers who set up braais or barbecues in front of their shops at weekends to grill their meat and sell it to the locals. Nowadays, local community gathers at braais and weekends to share good music and food. Pop along to soak up a vibrant atmosphere. Listen to music, relax and take your pick on the menu, usually comprising of beef, chicken, pork, lamb or wors, well known as a sausage. This one is not an outing for vegetarian guys, sorry. Number 5. Chakalaka and pap. Chakalaka and pap are mainstays on every South African dinner table. Chakalaka is a vegetable dish made from onions, tomatoes, peppers, carrots, beans and spices. It is often served cold. Pap, meaning porridge, which is often similar to an American grits, and it is a starchy dish made from a white corn maize meal. Chakalaka and pap are often served together, along with a braaied or barbecued meat. This is a dish that will leave you full, but you'll still want some more. Number 4. Malva pudding. A Dutch import. Malva pudding is a sweet and sticky baked sponge pudding made with apricot jam and served smooth as a hot cream sauce. This is South Africa's answer to the British sticky toffee pudding. Maggie was the inventor of the now well-known Malva pudding, which is legendary in South Africa and after 50 years featured on most restaurant dessert menus. Many inventions of the original recipe has been tasted without a doubt, but the original, as Maggie has written it down, proved to be the best. It is served in many restaurants but mainly baked at home for Sunday lunch. Number 3. Cape Malay curry. In the 17th century, the Dutch and French landed and settled in Cape Town, bringing slaves from Indonesia, India, and Malaysia. They brought them along with their spices and traditional cooking methods. When combined with local produce, the aromatic spices such as cinnamon, saffron, and turmeric and chili created fragrance curries and stews, which are still very popular even today. Try making your own. Cape Malay curry is very distinctive and relies on bold fruity flavors and aromas. When you combine sweet and savory flavors, you will not go wrong. And they are not quite as hot and spicy as some of the Indian curries. The Cape Malay curry is a special blend of spices not found in other dishes and originates from the Bokkap. If you find yourself in Cape Town, make sure to buy a Cape Malay curry. Your mouth will be filled with wonders. Number 2. Boerewors. This is a traditional South African sausage made from beef, mixed with either pork or lamb, and a mixture of spices. Boerewors are traditionally served in coil shape, similar to the Cumberland sausage, and cooked on a braai, well known as a barbecue. The word boerewors comes from the Afrikaans and Dutch. The word boere means farmer, and the wors, which means sausage. And you might ask yourself, what is the difference between a sausage and a boerewors? As you can see, the main difference between a boerewors and a sausage is the percentage of meat in the product. Boerewors is generally more expensive because it contains a higher percentage of meat. However, sausages can be just as delicious and it offers a better value for money. Number 1. Biltong and droewors. Dry cutting was a method used to preserve meat by the indigenous tribes of South Africa before fridges were invented. Usually made from beef or game such as springbok, biltong is a tiny sliced air-dried meat, and droewors is a tiny dried sausage that is traditionally eaten as a snack. The meat is cured in a mixture of vinegar, salt, sugar, pepper, and spices, then hung to dry. The finished product is prized by health enthusiasts for its high protein and low fat content. Nowadays, biltong and droewors producers often add flavors such as chili or garlic. Some even use variety of meats such as ostrich and wild boar. Fresh and healthy biltongs are found in local petrol stations and retail shops. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please like and be sure to hit that subscribe button to get more videos like this one. See you in the next episode.